talk to you. I don't know how to ask you if you're okay. My friends always feel the need to tell me things. Seems like they're just happier than us these days. Yeah. These days I don't know how to talk to you. I don't know how to be there when you need me. It feels like the only time you see me is when you turn your head to the side and look at me differently. Yeah. And last night, I think I lost my patience. Last night, I got high as the expectations. Last night, I came to a realization, and I hope you can take it. I hope you can take it all. I'm too good to you. I'm way too good to you. You take my love for granted. I just don't understand it. No, I'm too good to you. I'm way too good to you. You take my love for granted. I just don't understand it.
I don't know how to talk to you. I just know I find myself getting lost with you. Lately, you just made me work too hard for you. Got me on flights overseas and I still can't get across to you. And last night, I think I lost my patience. Last night, I got high as the expectation. Last night, I came to a realization. And I hope you could take it. I hope you could take it all.
I'm too good to you. I'm way too good to you. You take my love for granted. I just don't understand it. No, I'm too good to you. I'm way too good to you. You take my love for granted. I just don't understand it. Years go by too fast. I can't keep track. How long did we last? I feel bad for asking. It can't end like this. We gotta take time with this. Cock up your bomba, sit down, bonita. Let me see if this is something I can fix. Yeah. You got somebody other than me. Don't play the victim when you're with me. Free time is costing me more than it seems. Sacrificing things, and I wanna tell you my intentions. I wanna do the things that I mentioned. I wanna benefit from this friendship. I wanna get the late night message from you. From you. I put my hands around you. Gotta get a handle on you. Gotta get a handle on the fact that I'm too good to you. I'm way too good to you. You take my love for granted. I just don't understand it. No, I'm too good to you. I'm way too good to you. You take my love for granted. I just don't understand it.
That's Too Good by Drake and Rihanna. I swear that song could have been made in South Africa. Because it's got such a South African house vibe. Like, it's ridiculous. When I first heard it, I was like, dude, this dude made an album for the world. Because his sounds are, like, all over the place. Even the one dance instrumental I'm using to speak, it's got a lot of Niger influence in there. But anyway, so have you chosen the two variables that you have, like where you are right now, right? So let's talk a little bit more about why this is crucial. I had a friend of mine who I used to work with in the Philippines, and she was very hardworking, you know, very beautiful woman, very hardworking, but she was also very committed to her family, right? So she used to complain that I'm never gonna get a boyfriend, and it's so hard to meet people, it's so hard to get a guy. And I said to her, look, every waking moment of your life, it's either you're with your family or you're with us, your workmates. Unless you're going to date your family, which is a hell no, right? Or unless you're going to date someone in the office, where are you going to meet these people, right? So for her, she hadn't clearly defined, she, without knowing, she was actually a CR, right? But because she hadn't adjusted her life accordingly, she was a too, she had too much C in there, right? So she never made the time to go out. She used to put her hand up for the weekend assignments. She used to, you know, stay behind late, and you know, because commuting in the Philippines is a nightmare, you really don't want to make the decision to try and go out and anywhere other than just straight home. And she was very happy to do that. On the weekends, it was family time. So she never made the time to meet someone. And so she was not content with her relationship life, but that's because she hadn't made the necessary adjustments. You see, when you decide that you are CF, right? You're about your career, you're about your personal freedom. You make the necessary adjustments. You commit more time to work, you put your hand up for the weekend assignments, you come home, you do the overtime, etc., as well as you schedule in me time. You know, you download your binge movies and you do that, or you make time for your girlfriends or your boyfriends, your guy friends, sorry, where you just chill and you play sport here once in a while for a recreation, but you're not going to be really open to try and meet someone so you can start dating, exchanging numbers, and then, you know, going through the motions. Like, you're not ready. So you set your life accordingly. But when you switch and now you want to be in a relationship, right, you stop taking those extra commitments at work, right? You stop focusing so much on your career and you start actually now making time to going out and meeting people, right? So if you used to finish work late, you start finishing a little bit earlier so that you get into the mode of leaving work at work and then going home and doing, you know, stuff that more in line with trying to meet someone. You know, on the weekends, you go out to different places. Don't just go to the same places, your church, your friend's house, and etc. Because you're not going to meet many people out there unless you're about the referral game, which is not bad because referrals from friends is actually one of the best ways of meeting people these days anyway. My point is you start to make the necessary adjustments in your life to suit the decision that you're making, right? A lot of people don't make the adjustments, right? So with the friend I was talking to who was upset about the conversation which she had with her aunt, I said, you sound like a CF to me, right? You're about your career and you want your freedom. The last thing you're thinking about is a dude. So if you know you're a CF, be happy in your CF, right? Don't start getting FOMO over not being a CR because you're not committed to being a CR. When you become a CR, then you're a CR. Remember, CR meaning career and relationships. When you become that, that's when it happens, right? So as long as you say to yourself you're a CF, be happy in that, right? So that, but then remember, in the background, right, you can hear the desire to want a person in their life. You can hear the desire for companionship. Which is why I'm not going to define three types of relationship styles. Remember, I'm about commitment, but I also believe 100% that the reason why a lot of people's relationships don't work, or a reason why people don't have the desired relationships they want, I already mentioned it earlier, is because you haven't clearly defined where you are in your life and what you want, right? So there's three types. You can either be dating, you can be dating exclusively, or you can be courting, right? A lot of people get these three things messed up, right? When you're dating, that means you go out and you go on dates with guys or girls, whichever way you swing, and you just have conversations, you have some form of companionship, you're not trying to be in love with them, you're not going to go meet their parents or go see their friends and become part of the crew and, you know, have their friends look at you like, how long is she going to be here or how long is he going to be here? You're just going on and having fun. It's not even with the same person. You can go out on a date on Monday with this person, on Tuesday with another person, on Thursday with another person, on Saturday with another person. You're just literally keeping your skills of interacting with the opposite sex up and polished and enjoying yourself. I think that's the situation that's cool for someone who's CF, where you can allocate a bit of your personal freedom time to spending time with someone from the opposite sex, just to enjoy yourselves, you know, just, you know, go and spend time with someone, right, as opposed to with Kevin Spacey in the House of Cards, right? Then when you're talking about dating exclusively, now, this is very tricky because you need to be extremely emotionally mature to be able to handle this situation really well. When you're dating exclusively, it means you say to someone, I'm not interested in going out Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday with Tom, Dick, and Harry or Mary, Sue, and Sally. I'm interested in doing that just with you. Now, the problem is, when you're dating exclusively, it's different from the third thing, which I'm going to talk about, which is courting. See, because when you're dating exclusively, you've just made a commitment to companionship with one person, right? There's nothing, it's serious, but it's not too serious, right? It's just something that keeps you going. But courting is when you're now going through the motions to get married. That's when you go and see the person's family. That's when you go and see the person's friends. That's when you have those conversations of where are we going? What is this? What are we? Those big, dreaded, tough conversations that people love to have and put pressure on themselves, right? That's when you're courting. Courting is making the moves towards that long commitment that we call marriage. But when you're dating exclusively, it just means I'm not going to be going on a random date with anybody else. I'm just going to be committing my time to being your friend. We're going to be a friend. And you know, friends, depending on how you swing, you can be friends with benefits as well, or you can just be friends and you don't have sex with each other. I don't care how you organize your friendships, as you do you, boo-boo. But that's what it simply means. So dating, you're just going out with as many people as you can, man. You're just using that personal freedom time, you know? That is perfect for someone who's 22, 23. You just want to be focusing on your career, but you also want to be able to get some interest going from the opposite sex. That's perfect, right? Then when you're about, you're 28, 29, and you're now trying to, you know, you're sick of the randoms, right? You want something a little bit more, you know, mainstream, more settled down, more mature. Then you move into CR, where you now make adjustments to look for that person who you can date exclusively. You know, this is your friend, this is your companion. You're committed to just knowing them and just spending time with them. So your personal freedom, you allocate it to them. And then, you, of course, when you graduate from that, you go into the courting. That's when you start the process of getting to know each other's families, etc., etc. So, you know, it's important to know these things, because when you interact with people who are in different places, you understand what to leave and what to invest in. So if you're a CF and you meet a CR, I've seen this so many times. Someone just wants to have fun. They just want to hang out with you because you're a dude, or you just want to hang out with a girl, but I don't want to be in a relationship. So when you meet someone who's a CR, you know that in this place, I shouldn't invest in getting to know this person too well, because they're going to want more from me than I'm able to give. And everybody's got that person in their phone book, that person who, you know, if you just say, hey, their world lights up and they're going to be like, what are you doing next week? Oh my gosh, you should come and do brunch with my friends. You should totally, wall up. I ain't ready for that. Okay. Right. So if you know they're a CF and you meet up with the CR, don't invest in that. If you're a CR and you meet with the CR, make the investment. You never know where it could go. I'm not saying you have to marry that person, but make the investment, because you're both in the same place in your life. You're both looking for the same things, right? So do what's necessary in order to make that work, you know? And the thing is, when you know how, when you've clearly defined where you're at and you know what you want, you can handle your relationships accordingly. So when your aunt says to you, where's your man? You say, I'm not looking for a man, but I am open to dating, just, you know, figure out some things about the opposite sex. And when you're dealing with people and people come with all sorts of their own agendas, someone loves you more than you love them, even love is strong, likes you more than you like them, you know how to handle that situation appropriately. You don't invest in it. So that's pretty much what I wanted to talk about. That's the triangle of expectations. Of course, I can't say everything, and I'm probably not doing justice to a lot of other variables, but talk to me, tell me about it, and I might just do an episode about it. This is the best song on Lemonade, by the way, and I will play it in the next episode, which I'll be doing straight after this. But yeah, man, I hope you learned something. I hope you picked up something. Take the time to figure out the triangle. Take the time to figure out which are your two variables and which one is going to suffer for now, and have fun with it, you know. And because for me, I'll tell you right now, I'm in CF, right? I'm committed to my career, and I love my personal freedom. I love to be able to do the DJ Dela show. When I have a girlfriend, you'll see that this show is going to be suffering, but that's not where I'm at right now, and hope you love it, and I'm out.